Hey guys, welcome to my channel Isha Super Worlds, and today I'm going to show you a story that I had written myself. So let's begin. A Strange Footprint, an Adventure. A Strange Footprint. Let's begin. Once, when I was taking a walk on the wooden plank near the harbour, I saw some footprints of a little kid. At first, I thought that they were children of normal sailors and captains, and went home. But at night, I had a strange thought. The docks were wooden, so it was very peculiar that there would be footprints on wood. And moreover, everybody walks wearing shoes. So how come I could see toes and heels and soles? There could not have been any beggar or poor child in a place where even normal people are not allowed without any rhyme or reason. I could not sleep that night. I kept thinking about the footprint. The next day, as soon as school finished, I ran home, dumped my bag, got my magnifying glass and my scuba gear, and went straight to the harbour. At first, I saw nothing suspicious, but as I went further, I saw more footprints like this one. I followed the footprints all the way to the beach and next to the ocean, when suddenly they stopped. I thought of it to be very curious for the footprints to just stop there, as if the owner had jumped into the water. Aha! That's it! The owner must have jumped into the water. Next, I went home and rang up some of my friends. Bhargavi and Stuti agreed to come. We decided that we would meet at the beach at 12 a.m. with waterproof binoculars and flashlights, scuba gear, a camera and snacks. I got to the beach at 11:55 and got ready in my scuba costume. Before the girls arrived, I decided to have another look at that footprint. As I examined it closely, I saw the print of a fin right next to the footprint. I called my friends and told them about this. They said, "Isha, I think you are hallucinating. How can there be a fin so close to shore?" I sighed and put down my bag. When the girls arrived, I took them straight to the beach. They too agreed that it was a fin. We got into our scuba gear at one and went in. We didn't see it much at first, but as we went deeper, saw some interesting and amazing creatures. We took lots of pictures, but we could not find the source of the footprint. When Bhargavi shot up to the surface, we followed. When we got up, she said that she might have seen a long red tail right next to a school of sardines. We went in again and looked around. When we heard a loud screaming noise. We all swam up to the surface and went home. I was still very afraid because the noise could have been a serious danger to us all. The next morning I was feeling better, so I went to investigate again. This time I too saw a tail and my fright was back. I went home, changed into my uniform and went to school. Today was a science contest I wasn't taking part in, so there was many robots and potions around me. After fourth period, the contest started and the students who weren't taking part could vote for the winner. So I too went in the corridor and looked around when I saw a robot with a familiar tail. It was the one I saw earlier. As I stood there looking at the little machine with surprise, somebody pulled me in a classroom and blindfolded me. Then I heard a familiar voice, Stuti's voice, and then Bhagavi's. I heard voices of many of my friends, including Vidhi, Vivaswan, and Nithil. When the blindfold was removed, I saw that I was in our science lab with a large banner on the front that said April Fools. It was all a surprise. I was very happy that the monster was not real, but very angry about the prank they played on me. after school ended, you might have seen me and my friends discussing about the wonderful little prank for which I had to go scuba diving 2 times a day. Thank you. Yes, all this whole story has been written by me, and all the characters in the story are fictional. Any resemblance to any person is completely accidental, and all the images have been found on Google. So yes, thank you very much, and I hope you enjoyed the story. And if you want me to write more stories and make more presentations like this, please tell me in the comment section below. Bye bye.